A mixed-race woman is the Duchess of Sussex. Attitude towards interracial relationships are evolving. Or are they? Next on A Seat at the Table. So I like what I see when I'm looking at me when I'm walking past the mirror. Don't stress through the night at a time in my life. Ain't worried about if you feel it. Got my head on straight, I got the vibe right. I ain't gonna let you kill it. See, I won't change. Welcome to A Seat at the Table. I'm Monica Pearson, and that wedding was gorgeous.
I'm Christine White, and today we're talking about interracial relationships.
And I'm Deneen Milner. It's been just over 50 years since interracial marriage was legalized nationally. In 1967, the Supreme Court case Loving versus Virginia broke the barriers of who a person could love. Take a look.
It was about 2 a.m. and I saw this light, you know, and I woke up and it was the policeman standing beside the bed, and he told us to get up, that we was under arrest. And in January, they had the trial, and they told us to leave the state for 25 years.
I said, I think that marrying who you want to is a right that no man should have anything to do with. It's a God-given right, I think.
Anytime love wins, I'm happy. Love wins against racism. Love wins against sexism. Love wins against the patriarchy. I'm happy.
Have you ever dated a white man?
No.
Have you ever dated outside your race? Meaning?
No.
So you only date black men?
I've only dated black men. I actually did kiss a Jewish guy when I was in high school one time, but no, we never dated, so.
So I'm curious, what color black men do you date?
I don't know. Whichever ones I like.
Because, you know, sometimes people have favorites.
But wait, would you date a white guy?
Would you date a white guy?
I've never been in a situation where I've had to make that decision.
I dated a white guy when I was in college. And he was a perfectly nice guy. His name was Rich. And then I took him home. And James Jr. was standing at the top of the steps when we walked through the door. And he, the look on my father's face, and he literally said, who are you and why are you here? And I was like, ooh, okay. And immediately there was just like this pall over the energy. And I was just like, okay, we're gonna leave. And I broke up with him within a week.
Well, I dated a white guy, I could even tell you the year, 1975, because that's when I came to Atlanta. And I've recently divorced, met this young guy who was good looking, tall, great body, blonde hair, blue eyes, who thought I was everything. And the only reason I stopped dating him was because in 1975 in Atlanta, a black woman who is this brown with a white man turned heads. Yeah. And because of my job being, you know, the first African-American and a woman to do the 6 o'clock news, it actually could have been a hindrance to my career. Mm-hmm. So I had to step back and say, as cute and fine as you are, we can't date.
That's a shame.
But did you love him? I mean, if you had loved him, if he was your love, would you have broken up with him because he was white?
Yes, because guess what? I had to pay my bills.
Yeah.
And that contract at WSB TV meant more to me than no matter how much that love was.
I hear that.
I mean, that was reality.
I'm sorry, but Miss Thing here still hasn't answered the question. You ain't slick.
I don't know what you want me to say.
Would I date a white man?
Yes. I am sure I would date a white man if there was a white man that I liked. I've never met a white man that I've actually, I mean, that's not true. When I was in kindergarten, I loved Ricky Schroeder. Loved Ricky Schroeder.
That doesn't
and
count.
Actually, I had a really, like, huge crush on a guy that I went to law school with who would not come near me. Like, when he found out I liked him, we were cool, we were study buddies, but then he found out I liked him, and he was like, not happening. I am from the middle of nowhere, Georgia. So, you know, I don't think I've ever had to test that hypothesis.
Well, I think what's going to happen after the show, somebody's going to call you up and ask you out, and we're going to see. Well, for some interracial relationships, things are taboo, and there are many biases. For instance, some say it's okay for a black woman to date a white man, but get upset with a black man who dates a white woman, and vice versa. You know, this is a tangled web. Here's one black woman's reaction to an interracial couple from a recent episode of Atlanta.
Yeah, I'm staring at you.
Is there a problem?
Not really. Saddled over there with your black man accessory, and I'm just tired of that story, to be honest. It's basic.
Maybe I'm just a good woman.
There are plenty of good black women, but you don't see Brad Pitt trying to date Shonda Rhimes. Type beautiful woman in Google Images, honey. Then you can talk to me.
Well, okay, I'm gonna put my buddy on the spot over here because you have a definite view. My dear.
Ma'am.
If your son brought home a white woman, how would you feel? And if your daughters brought home a white man, how would you feel? Because I know the answer.
If my son brought home a white woman, which he would not.
How do you know?
Which he would not. I'd respond the same way that that character did in Atlanta. There are plenty of beautiful black women for you to choose from. Why would you put yourself into this sort of this dynamic where you're dealing with a woman who may not understand and be able to relate to and help you through all of the different things that you would have to go through as a black man in America?
Isn't it the same for your daughters?
Not the same as for black men. And yes, but I think that when you're talking about the intersection of gender and race, you bring a whole nother element in when you're talking about black women being able to fall in love and be married. The pool just is smaller for black women if you want to date exclusively black men. And so if they want to be in love and there's someone who absolutely loves them, I'm cool with it. It's fine. I would prefer that it be a black man, but if it's not like a Boricua from, you know, New York, from the Bronx, I'm cool with that.
So I'm biased.
I think we need to dispel the myth, though. Black men love black women. So I do know that there are statistics that say that a black man is more likely than a white man to date outside his race. But the truth is that black men overwhelmingly love and marry and pair up with black women.
That's true. But you know what? When you're talking about black men who date white women, I don't know if this is true for all of them, but the overriding sentiment always seems to be, well, I'm dating a white woman because black women are angry, they're mean, they're gold diggers. They attach all of these horrible stereotypes to us as they're going to the other side. Brother, if you want to go to the other side, go on over there.
Right.
But don't, you know,
disparage
me, yes, while you're doing it. Go over there and love her, but don't talk about me and make me feel like I'm somehow lesser than because you chose to go and, you know, be with a white girl.
I agree with you. And I think that the issue is that black man who doesn't recognize that our entire society has placed white women on a pedestal, who have said that white women are the standard for beauty, they're the standard for femininity. If you don't understand that that's the message you've been getting your whole life, first of all, I don't want to date you because I need you to understand the context of the world that we live in.
Right.
And number two, then you're going to fall into that pitfall without even knowing it.
Exactly.
So you're just falling into the line of this idea of white supremacy without even giving any thought to the way that oppression has affected black women. And I'm not with that.
Well, right? I can tell you this. I've seen so many black men lately have a black wife the first marriage, a white wife the second marriage.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I was talking about it was a problem in 75, but now you have many black reporters on air who are married to white men, mm-hmm, or a white woman. So the times have changed, and maybe it has to do with the way they were raised in a more integrated society than I was raised in, where it was truly taboo, or it was felt that if a white man dated a black woman, it was like the slave master picking the black woman. And it was just taboo.
Yeah, there are also, I think, cultural reasons why black men tend to date white women. I think that
they put up with. Nah. I don't want to generalize, but a lot of them will take what we just won't take.
Right.
We want a black man working. They will just take him and hope to develop him. And that's generalizing. Not everybody's like that.
Sips tea.
Well, we have to take a quick break, but when we come back, we'll be joined by someone who faces the daily realities of being in a relationship with a person of another race.
Mrs. Drayton, I'm medically qualified, so I hope you wouldn't think it presumptuous if I say you ought to sit down before you fall down, I mean.
He thinks you're gonna faint because he's a Negro.
Did you tell them?
What? Tell them what?
Babe, don't.
What?
Did you...
A cute, clean-shaven white.
Pigment challenge. Did you tell them that I'm white?
You're white? You're white? It was a joke, sir. I was kidding.
Welcome back to A Seat at the Table. We're now joined by Chelsea Tafoya, a freelance TV producer and host here at Georgia Public Broadcasting. So Chelsea, thank you for joining us.
Good morning.
You've been with your husband for 12 years, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Tell us about how that came to be.
We actually met in a Target, believe it or not. I saw him. He had on like this little purple outfit. Hey, the note is I approached him. That's the note.
I approached him.
Literally, yeah. I went up to him. I was like, "You look good, brother. Hey, you know what's up?"
You called him brother?
My man. I think I called him my man.
Okay.
Hey, my man, you look good. Since we're talking about the subject, it wasn't brother.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
So then we kind of chatted, exchanged numbers. We never thought we would actually, you know, reach out later on. The next morning, we had classes together, summer classes at Georgia State. Oh. So it was meant to be.
Literally
10 o'clock
wow.
the next morning, 10
that
hours
makes
later.
Feel good.
Okay.
Yes.
What year was this?
That was about 12 years ago. So 2007.
And you're in your early,
so,
late
30s.
20s, your early,
early
30s. 30s. See, this is generational.
Yeah.
When you were in high school, did you date white guys?
I did not. You know, and something we kind of talked about earlier is I never was really approached. I grew up in Alpharetta. So all white area. I never had like a white guy come up to me. They'd be like, "Oh, you look good, girl," and stuff like that. They never really wanted to date me per se. Mm-hmm. Not until I got to college. Mm-hmm. And it also might have to do with me being open to it and how you present yourself, you know, being open up to that. But when I got to college is when I dated my first, really outside my race, not just white, but
what
outside
about
my
him?
Race period.
Had he dated outside of his race?
Yes, he has a preference for the sisters. He has the preference for us sisters. So
well, I don't know. You saw that coming then. I don't know how you figured that part
so
out.
So wait a minute. How did his parents, particularly his mother, feel
so
about
he
this?
He grew up in Denver. So his
Denver,
mother,
which is
Denver.
Really white.
Yeah, well, it's white and Hispanic mostly.
Yeah.
You know, but he grew up in an area of Denver that he liked basketball. He loves hip hop. I wish he was hair. So a lot of people, when they hear, "Oh, you know, your husband's white," they automatically think, "Oh, he's like a black acting white guy." But no, my husband is himself. He is very much white. He works, you know, in the stock market. So he doesn't act black in any kind of way. Mm-hmm. But he's very comfortable with a lot of the things that black culture is comfortable with, like basketball. Hip hop. He knows more about hip hop than any other person, much less black person I've ever met. Mm. But back to his mother. His mother really raised him to be colorblind. She was very specific about raising both of her children very colorblind, which to me, of course, growing up in Georgia, that ain't no thing. What's colorblind?
Right.
You can't
right.
be colorblind mm-hmm. as a
right.
black person, as we all know. Right. I see someone black every time I look in the mirror,
right.
and I see someone black as other people look at me.
Right.
You know, I know they recognize me to be black. So
right. And clearly he's not colorblind because you said that he prefers black women.
Yeah, I think he prefers black women because of our culture and how we treat ourselves and how we kind of interact with people. I think that's more his thing. Mm-hmm. What we've discussed so far, that's
well,
what he said.
I've got to ask. You said he's, you know, in stockbroker. That's traditionally a very conservative.
Yes.
So when he walks in with you, what has been the reaction?
It's funny when they hear that, you know, "Oh, my wife is black," same thing. They think, "Oh, she's going to be like Bone Quisha and this and that." And then when they see me, it's really funny because he actually mentioned it first. They give me that look of like, "Oh, she's not like a real black girl." Like, "Oh, we get that whole thing.
That would drive me
crazy. Yeah, and, you know, I'm just me too. I'm not colorblind, definitely not, but I'm very proud of my race and all of that kind of stuff, but...
Right. Okay, help me with this one.
Because I need to, I want to interrogate that part about you walking in and people being comfortable with you.
Yes.
As opposed to, say, me walking in with my chocolate skin and my, you know, locks and me being unapologetically like, hey, I'm a black woman, and I'm not saying that you're not like that.
Yeah.
But there is a difference between the way that you present to white men versus the way that I present to white men. And I don't have to open my mouth to say anything. There's a lot of assumptions that come with...
It's attitude.
But I'm not walking around like... Forget white men. You can't get none of this. I'm not doing that. You can't have none of this ever. I'm not doing that.
But I have found that white men tend to like brown women. Like when they date, with the white men that I've seen date black women, date very black presenting, brown, natural hair women. Yeah. And I always thought, I mean, I'm just gonna say, I always thought that they ain't like light-skinned girls, but now I know.
I will say it's a different impression, but when it comes down to them thinking anything negative, let's be real, black is black. It doesn't matter what you look like. Right. So yes, I do present myself in a different kind of way or whatever, or they may perceive me to be a different way. I get the question, oh, what do you mix with? Not even are you mixed, but what do you mix with? Yeah. And I'm like, I mix with black.
Right. Okay? And black and black.
I get
black
that
black
a lot. Black. But,
So did you have to teach him about white supremacy, white privilege, racism? Like, did you have to teach him the intersection of racism and sexism? Did you have to teach him about that?
I will say we both learned throughout the process, because he definitely opened my eyes up to a lot of the things that I feel and interactions of myself and how I interact with other people a lot. You know, he helped me to realize, wow, growing up in Georgia, like, I do have a view of being black and what race and color is. Because I was like, okay, what is this colorblind thing?
Right.
One thing I did teach him about is the look we get. Now, we all know we get that look, you know, and I get that look just walking by myself. So we are total opposites. I'm short, he's tall, obviously, I'm black, he's white. So people will look at us, and he didn't understand the look until he understood the look.
Right.
And then he was like mad about the look. Like, man, why are they looking at us? Why are they looking? I'm like, boy, we used to it. We get that look all the time.
Right.
You know?
Right. I want to know how your parents feel about your interracial marriage and interracial dating. How did
My parents.
Right.
My mom is Caribbean, so she grew up in a Caribbean culture. We have everybody. We have black, white, whatever. So very encompassing. But my dad grew up very strongly African-American. I mean, he had us watching Four Little Girls at a young age. He was like, my grandfather was also in the civil rights movement. He walked with Martin Luther King. He did all of that kind of stuff. So we grew up that way. So my poor daddy. I have two brothers, both of them, which are dating white women as well. And so my daddy was like, man, you gonna bring it in for me, baby girl? And then, sorry, daddy, I didn't bring it in for him. I ended up, but I dated everybody. The guy I dated prior to my husband was your skin tone. So, you know, I never really had a preference. It was just everybody for me. But he was like, you gonna give me a chocolate grandbaby? She gonna look like me? And now I'm like, oh, sorry.
Well,
daddy.
It still could happen if you saw Imitation of Life. You still could have a chocolate baby.
That's true.
That?
Or so even Tamara, because, you know, she prayed for a second kid that was brown skin. Hey, honey, give me a second one.
With this one, tell her why she should not get upset with her son if he brings a white woman home.
Well, first of all, you said there are many black women, you know, out there and this and that, but God, love is so finicky. Love is just, you know, and it's something that there are gonna definitely be things that people won't understand, and that is something I will say that between us and between our marriage, we have a lot of discussions about it. And sometimes at the end of the day, I just have to say, look, baby, there's nothing I can say or do. You're not going to understand this. You know, we do have a lot of those conversations. And I think earlier in our conversation or in our relationship, we had a lot of conversations about affirmative action and things like that. He's not conservative. By any means, but he's also not like a Republican and super liberal. He's more himself. He kind of thinks of his...
Independent,
very much so. But yeah, at the end of the day, I just had to say, look, there are things that you're not going to understand. So for that factor, you know, we're a mama, man. Wish for love.
He can find out with a black girl. I'm immovable with that one.
Wow.
I am.
That's crazy. If he comes home with a white woman, get married, have a baby, you're going to be the greatest.
It'll be fine, but I'm letting him know what my preference is.
There's
and
just
my
so
preference
much...
is that he be a black man who loves a black woman, just like a black woman gave birth to him and another black woman helped to raise him. Well, you go on ahead and do that for
and
me.
And I feel you, because I feel like, particularly hearing your story about the love that you found, and I mean, it's so heartening. And I know that for black women, I mean, it's not just that the pool is smaller if you only want to date black men. The pool is smaller, period.
Right.
I mean, I've heard stories of, you know, men when they go on Tinder or whatever these little apps are, they're not going to check black women.
Right.
Like, Asian
Absolutely.
Men aren't going to check black women. Like, right. they may check everything else,
Nobody
but they're
does.
Not going to check
oh,
black
that's
women.
True.
It is true. You look at the statistics, it is true.
And so
what
I'm
was
excited.
It, Match.com or one
right.
of them
right.
actually did a study right. that showed that black women are the least picked out of every woman on the site. Black women are the least
but
picked by everybody.
Site. That's the reason why no. they're on sites now.
But that's
also
the reality. That is
black
exactly
women.
The reality. I
black
can
women
tell
have
you.
Left choices. And the truth of the matter is, I'm excited that you found you a white man. Mm-hmm. I'm excited you found a man, period.
Right.
Because black women have less choices. And I mean, I think that there are amazing men out here, but black women do face, I think, an uphill battle when you compare them to women of other races.
And let me tell you something about my son. He's brilliant. He's beautiful. He's got a great job. He's got a great career.
Amen.
He's an engineer. He lives on his own. He's independent. Might I add again that he's beautiful? And I want him to make beautiful brown babies.
So
with
wait,
a brown
so wait,
woman
I have a question then. I
and
have a
make
question.
A strong, beautiful so, black family
wait, wait, so
that
have,
we need to see.
I have a question then.
Mm-hmm.
So would you think, what would you think if he brought someone who was black but lesser than?
What do you mean?
So I mean, if he brought, so would you rather him, and this is, we're talking generalizations, right? Mm-hmm. So what if he brought a black woman in and she checks that box, but she's not up to your par?
Oh, no.
She don't go to everything.
She's not allowed
you just
either. We've
about.
Had that conversation. I'm very clear. I've been very clear on what works for him. You can play all you want to, but when it comes to who you're going to build a life with, there are a bunch of things that you need to be really cognizant about. You need to be very careful about the choices that you make and how those choices play out for you as a black man in America and for her as a black woman in America. And so, no, you don't get to bring home the dimwit. No, you don't get to bring home somebody who doesn't know how to be a strong black woman who's going to be there for you and can hold herself down if you're not. He's very clear. We've been very clear about that. It's not just about race. He's a thoroughbred. I expect him to bring home a stallion.
Hey. Well, our facial expressions,
now,
our body is now getting very popular.
But
you
now
know?
You
so,
see why white men don't come near her, because she walks in with that attitude
Zips
of,
tea
this
again.
Is my world, and you might belong in it. Well, my final thought is this for my daughter. I've always said to her, marry someone who treats you as well as your father, who is intelligent, who adores your dirty drawers and treats you good. And it doesn't matter to me whether he's black, white, Hispanic, Asian. I just want someone who literally will treat her as her father has raised her and treats her.
Yeah. I think that the biggest issue for me with interracial dating is back to values. I don't know if I could date a black man or a white man who didn't understand how a white supremacy and white privilege works in this world. And so, you know, I am excited that to know that relationships can happen regardless of race, and I always want love to win no matter what. But I do know that I think people should be cognizant of the way that oppression has affected black women, and I would expect black men to make choices understanding that.
How are you feeling after this whole conversation?
I'm feeling like we need a round two. I need to come back here, a seat at the table. I put my butt imprint on this one. I'm ready. I need some cards. Let's go. I'm gonna get to my host.
The only thing I'd like to add to it is a man married to a white woman to round it out.
I like that.
Well, I'll tell you that, I still stand firm.
And how I feel about that. He brings somebody home.
My daddy did give us trouble. So I will, he gave us trouble. And now the two of them are best friends. It's hilarious.
Right. I will love whoever he chooses to love, but he knows what the preference is. Mm-hmm. That's all there is to it. And, you know, I'll reiterate, I am in Georgia. Maybe it would be different if I were still in New York, but I'm in Georgia. I am invisible to white men. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I won't say that it's not okay because it's bothersome that I'm invisible to white men. So holla.
Right, because we're going to have letters all day after this.
You too are going to get lots of letters.
Thank you so much, Chelsea, for the opportunity. We want to continue this conversation no matter what. I know we do internally, so this is great.
Thank you for being at our table. Mm-hmm. We have to go, but the conversation doesn't have to end here.
Share your thoughts with us on social media.
We're on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest at ASATTTV. Thanks for joining us at A Seat at the Table. And in the words of Shirley Chisholm, if they don't give you a seat at the table,
bring a folding chair.